Hello everyone. Today we are going to start our new chapter, Unit 8, that is the D block and F block elements. It's important group. This chapter is important because all the exceptions are available in this chapter. We will study in this chapter Group A, Group D and Group F. First of all, we should know what is the D block and F block elements. D block elements whose actually this series of the transition metals, 3D series, 4D series and 5D series and 6D series, which come in this block. The D block of the periodic table contains the element of the group 3rd to 12, which the D orbitals are progressively filled in each of the four long periods, and F block consists of element in which 4F and 5F orbitals are progressively filled. They are placed in separate panel at the bottom of the periodic table. The names transition metals and inner transition metals are often used to refer to the elements of D block and F block respectively. What we can say, D block and F block is consist of period 4 to period 7, that is D block, and group 3 to group 12 in D block. Last electron in D subshell comes in D block, and this block is called transition metals. F last electron in the F subshell come in the M block, and this is called the inner transition metals. All other metals come in this group. Originally, the name transition metal was derived from the fact that their chemical properties were transitional between those of the S and P block elements. Now, according to IUPAC, transition metals are defined as metals which have incomplete D subshell, either in neutral atom or in their ions. Zinc, cadmium and mercury of group 12 have full D10 configuration in their ground state as well in their common oxidation states, so they are not registered as transition metals. The end member of the 3D, 4D and 5D transition series, their chemistry is studied along with the chemistry in the transition metal. The presence of partly filled D or F orbitals in their atoms make their transition elements different from that of the non-transition elements. Hence, transition elements and their compounds are studied separately. However, the usual theory of balance is applicable to the non-transition elements. Various precious metals such as silver, gold and platinum, and industrially important metals like iron, copper and titanium belong to the transition metal series. So in the simple word, we can say the element in which the last differentiating electron enters into the d orbitals of the penultimate shell, that is n-1d, where n is the last shell, are called the d block element. Now we are coming on the important thing, that is electronic configuration. In D block elements, with increase in atomic number, the D orbitals of the penultimate shell, that is n-1, the general electronic configuration is n-1, D1 to 10 and ns 1 to 2. What all are the physical properties of this group? Nearly all the transition elements display typical metallic properties such as high thermal and electrical conductivity and metallic luster. Now we will take all the physical properties then chemical properties of this block. First is the melting point and boiling point. High melting point and boiling point due to strong metallic bond and the presence of half filled d orbital. Involvement of greater number of electrons from n-1d in addition to the ns electron in the inner atomic metallic bonding. Because of a strong interatomic bonding, transition elements have high melting and boiling point. In moving along the period from left to right, the melting point of these metals first increase to maximum and then decrease regularly towards the end of the period. It is mentioned in the graph. Melting point of these metals rise to a maximum of D5 except the anomalous value of manganese and fall regularly as the atomic number increases. The strength of interatomic bonds in transition elements is roughly related to number of half-filled d orbitals. In the beginning of the number of half-filled d orbitals increase till the middle of the period causing increase in strength of interparticle bonds. But therefore the pairing of electron and d orbitals occur and number of half-filled orbital decreases, which also cause decrease in melting point. Trends in enthalpies of atomization of transition elements. The transition metals have high enthalpy of atomization due to the strong metallic bond, which is due to the smaller atomic size and additional covalent bond due to d-d overlapping. Greater the number of valence electron, stronger the interatomic attraction, hence a stronger bonding between atom resulting in higher enthalpies of atomization. Metals of the second and third series have greater enthalpies of atomization than the corresponding elements of the first series. Means atomic and ionic radii. The atomic and ionic radii first decreases till the middle, becomes almost constant, and then increases toward the end of the period. The atomic and ionic radii of transition elements are smaller than those of the S block elements and larger than those of the P block elements. As the atomic number increases, the atomic radii first decreases till middle, becomes almost constant, and then increase toward the end of the period. New electron enters a d orbital each time the nuclear charge increases by unity, but the shielding effect of the d electron is not the effective, hence the net electrostatic attraction between the nuclear charge and the outermost electron increases and the ionic radius decreases. What is the shielding effect? Shielding effect when the outermost electron is quite far from the nucleus. So the nucleus is not able to give the full attraction to the outermost electron because the s orbital electron give the repulsion to the outermost electron. However, the increased nuclear charge is partially cancelled by the increased screening effect of the electron in the d orbitals of penultimate shell. When the increased